All right, Navy SEALs. Death by Navy SEALs. No warm up, so I'm gonna warm up into it. I'm gonna be drinking water. Shout out to the burpee heads, the Navy SEAL people. Big admiration and respect for you guys. Super tight. It's gonna be a boring video, y'all. Thanks for checking in. I'm just doing Navy SEALs. So I'm clicking after every rep just so it can become such a robotic motion. It removes another thought of activity. It'll take some reps. Once I'm in that flow, bing, bing, bong. Bing, bing, bong. And I don't want to look at the number. And being that Navy SEALs give me such a hard time, I'm pacing myself and I'm trying to control the movement. You know what I'm saying? I'm not dropping down. I'm trying to do it properly. I'm gonna try to get a decent volume for me. And I'm very tight. I had a lot of big working out, big routines, and I feel it. So I'm going with the flow. Slow is smooth, smooth is fast. I'm not trying to burn out. I know I'm very sore, so I'm trying to keep that in mind because I'm gonna use it. I'm not gonna stop. This is for Jibe, the master and commander of Burpee Nation, no vacation. See my pacing, you know, it's very slow. I'm thinking like someone like Burpee Maddie and even Chris Shawarma. You can see how the movement is very fluid and intentional. I'm usually flopping around, jumping around. I just drop and pop. That's my style of burpee, calisthenic burpee, where you just drop and pop. This is more form oriented. And I'm not trying to be explosive. Just trying to go. Trying to be like a piston. But we'll get there. Right now, this is all mental. This fight is mental. We're just working mentally. Trust me. If you're not like a burpee bot, and you're trying to follow along with somebody at a pace, this is the pace you want to follow, because you should be able to keep up with me. I'm always the trail horse when it comes to burpees. And the reason is because I don't do them. So here we are doing them. Slow is smooth and smooth is fast. If I miss a click, that's my problem. There's no, I think I'm here, I think I'm there. Whatever they say, is what it is. If I miss one, that's my problem. What's my PR on Navy SEALs? Does anybody know? Remember, my goal is not time, it's value. Obviously, if you know me, you know what the goal is, but I'm not tripping over it. I almost don't want to hit the goal. Because I was going to be like, yo, bro, what happened? But I'm just dreaming big right now. Death by burpee. Burpicide. No idea what number I'm on. And it's not a lot. I know it's not. And how do I feel? My shoulders are burning already. and I'm purposefully moving slow. I'm purposely being deliberate in my reps. I'm deliberately trying to breathe. You know, and shout out to Navy SEALs because I'm already beginning to sweat. I'm not a heavy sweater. I could do 50 muscle-ups and not sweat. Do a 5MD and not sweat till I'm done. This is my my survival post. When you see me leaned over on this, I'm struggling. So I'll tell you this, what I think about flaring and tucking. I'm a tucker. I feel like when you flare, you target your chest more. When you tuck, you target your triceps more. Now your chest is a bigger muscle than your triceps. So I think that if you're flaring out, it's easier. You know, and I use the word easier liberally. I think it's a more productive way to get more reps. It's like doing chin-ups and you're focusing on your biceps to pull you up or your lats. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're going to get more reps with your lats because it's just a bigger and stronger muscle group. You know what I'm saying? But also, my hands are pretty close. Not quite a diamond, but pretty decently close. So I do feel my chest, especially when I'm popping. I feel it a lot when I'm popping. And I guess my strength will be the explosive movements. See, the slower I go, I'm getting a way better mind-muscle connection. And it allows me to consider my form. It gives me time to adjust, to remember to engage my core. You know? Keep my hips up. And I don't drop to the floor like I see some people do. I don't know what it means or what it's not. I don't do that. I don't want to touch the floor unless, you know, like I'm going down to it. I'm doing a push-up. I've seen professional burpee masters, like record breakers, where they just drop, their whole stomach is flat on the floor, like they release and get up. They drop, release, and get up. Hey, I don't know what the rules are, but not for me. I don't see the people I personally look up to doing it. And I just talk for some sort of entertainment value, and it helps me breathe. And I kind of talk myself up. This is therapy for me. This is medicine for me. So this allows me to talk to myself and not look like I'm absolutely crazy. But in reality, I'm batshit crazy. So, I have no idea the time or the rep. Those are the two least important things. The only thing is the action and the motive behind it. So I get what I get, and I get it when I get it. When I do check, then I make a determination of how I want to round off the time or round off the reps. At that point then, I'm going to gauge how many I average every 20 minutes. And then how much, how long it took me to get 50, etc. And compare it throughout. Then I have my yardstick. Shout out to O. I'm getting itchy for this 165 pound bench max and match. But I haven't been benching, so. But I've been in a good place where I've been able to train really hard and recover really fast. And I gotta think, what changes have I made? Because I haven't been sleeping, I haven't been eating. And it's not because I haven't wanted to, just haven't. For whatever reasons, I just going to bed late, waking up early. Haven't been making the appropriate time to eat properly. Well, my options are to eat something bad. I just choose not to eat. I have increased my fruit intake. So, been eating more apples, more oranges, grapes. So boom, that's the big difference. Eat a couple apples and you can do 1,000 pull-ups. And honestly, I think I get more done without a specific goal, without putting the pressure of the time. And I'm a big advocate for adding time. I'm a big advocate for trying to reach a rep total within a certain amount of time. And I'm an advocate for a setting amount of time and just going for the most you can get within that time frame. Those are the critical ways of training. But this is the classic way of just go until you're done. So I'm just trying to get what I get. And that's a beautiful way of training also, man. Takes a lot of pressure off, and it's just about each and every individual rep, you know? And hey, shout out to Brother Derek. Because Brother Derek is smoking the Navy SEALs. He caught, I think his PR is 105 in 20 minutes, and he hit 120 minutes twice. And if you've seen when he started doing Navy SEALs, it wasn't his thing, he just adapted to it. And now he's, you know, just getting better and better. Of course, if you look at all the training, he does a lot of stuff. He runs, he does steps, you know what I'm saying? And he lifts heavy weight. Even though not so much lately, he's probably like seasonal with it. In the winter, I would imagine he'd be lifting weights more. we took advantage of the summer being outside doing bodyweight stuff. And that's a great methodology of training. Because really all it really comes down to is doing something, right? And if you're doing different somethings, it keeps it interesting. You just gotta remember the stuff that really serves your best interest. Such as these godforsaken Navy SEALs. Pull-ups, dips, squats. Push-ups, one pumps, two pumps, yeah man, shout out to the burpee community man, to just wake up, right? Or go through your day and just do something difficult just for the sake of overcoming it. That takes a certain mind state. And that's not something that's easy to turn on and off. That has to just be the way you carry it for everything. Like, oh, this is gonna be difficult? Okay, I'll try. Simple as that. You know? And for the true artist of fitness, they show you the struggle. They show you the failures. They show you the hard work, the coming up short to the goal. They show you that. Those are the people I really mess with. It's not all, it's a highlight reel. You're gonna have some. You know what I'm saying? But, hey, like again, on Brother Derek. I appreciate his 100 clips because I seen when he didn't get them. You know what I'm saying? So now to see him get it, it's like, yo. And then you see the goals evolve. Shout out to G-Bay. I want to see what his total is at the end of the year. His reps. Total reps. And that video is gonna go viral. But he'd be like, 2023, I did 35,000 reps of burpees. Whew. Then you average that out. And then you could go through all the videos and be like, yo, not only did he do that, but he was still lifting weights. He was still doing some pull-ups and chin-ups, muscle-ups. He was still doing challenges. Yeah, man, that's the bro. Been a great guest on the GFTS show. With Crusades of Motivation, Double Osiris, and Outdoor Fitness. G-Bay's been a part of the show, and whenever he is, we chasing the rabbit. Because he got us stepping it up. You know? We appreciate that. I would say our community burpee master is really Osiris. No idea when I'm gonna. But I'll tell you what, you have never seen me do Navy SEALs for this long without crying. That's why I'm saying slow is smooth, smooth is fast. And I don't want to look at the number because it's going to be so discouraging. Honestly, the routine I was thinking about doing was an old Burpee Maddie routine called Score Attack. But I couldn't remember it. And rather than looking it up, I want to just start. So I'm like, hey, let me do some navies. But how am I gonna do them? That's when I decided to not go blowing my energy in the beginning when I haven't even warmed up. Because I feel like if I could glide into my second wind, you know, which happens, I get to a point where I can't do anymore and then I go numb. And once I go numb, I could pretty much match, or at least match half of what took me to that point. You know? Like, I know when I'm cooked, I got more. My cook tolerance, I can keep working. I mean, you know, not at the same level, but I know that when I'm done, I'm not finished. You know, so mentally I already came in with that attitude that this is gonna hurt, and when it does, live with it. Keep going. Shout out to Simon Simone Tregus, you know who I'm talking about. That those reps when he was doing the Jibe, when he would reach failure. And he couldn't even push himself up, but he never did stop. You know, like, he would fail on a rep, fall over, stand up, and keep going until he got to that point again, over and over again. Very commendable, and it was a display of mental fortitude. And that's what makes the high-level burpee practitioner successful. And that's what makes people in general successful. You know, because fitness is a lifestyle. But see, that lifestyle doesn't turn on and off just while you're doing it. It's a lifestyle all day long, your whole life. So it's how you handle everything. You know what I'm saying? And also I feel like, again, slow is smooth, smooth is fast. Take your time and hurry up. So rather than pushing and breathing heavy and resting, I'm just going slow and methodical, and I just keep clicking, one click at a time. Keep clicking. Long as the click is clicking, we're moving. I don't know how long I'm gonna go. And that's the beauty of the adventure. This is an adventure. An adventure of discovery, both physically and mentally. This is art. It's the art of Gainz. If I knew the time and if I knew the rep count, it would be more difficult to continue going. Because then I'm going to be factoring a future that is make-believe. You know, I'm not thinking about damn. I got X amount more to go. I'm not thinking, oh, I got X amount of time to go. All I have is, how do I feel right now in this moment? Good enough to go. And as long as I feel good enough for one more, then it's gonna fill up that time. And it's gonna fill up that rep count. And y'all know what my goal is. I'm not even gonna say it. And if I don't get it, I'm still gonna be stronger to get it in the future. I just figure now's a nice time to do it since I'm here already. I said I was gonna do it. I tried and failed many a time. But I'll tell you this, each attempt that I've tried and failed, and I don't know what number I'm on, but I'm pretty sure at this point I didn't feel as good as I feel right now. And that's because of the pacing and the methodology. And the fucking fruits. And also, you know, shout out to my bros. I have so many brothers a little down, going through real life stuff, man. You know? And that gives me like an energy, like, you know, transfer the energy. You know, I feel empathy for people I know that are hurting inside. And they just carry on and push, and y'all don't even know if y'all don't know. Y'all know who I'm talking about. Let me see if it's recording, because I'll just throw myself. I didn't see the time, promise. I tell you what, though, this wasn't recording. I wouldn't be able to carry on with the same vigor. Anybody who knows me know, even if I were secretly counting in my head, I'd have been lost count. I have no idea, not a clue. What I will review is, I'll analyze my pace. My pace per 10 minutes. My pace per 20 minutes, my pace per 100, or my pace per 50, depends what my total is. I'm super interested to see what number I'm on. I know it's lower than I want it to be. And it could be what I think. And I don't know if that would inspire me to go on or be satisfied. And I don't want to find out. Imagine if this was just 20 minutes. If I'm gonna guess, I'm gonna say I'm on 40 minutes. So if I'm guessing I'm on 40 minutes, I wanna do at least 20 more minutes. And if I'm guessing on my number, I'm gonna say about 150. In which case, if I do an additional 20 minutes at the pace of 75 per 20 minutes, then I'll finish at 225. Let's see. If it's less than 225, I'm gonna be super disappointed. And what'll be interesting is, what's the actual time for, like when I said I think it's 40 minutes, imagine it's really 20 minutes, and it's like, damn man, I'm actually feel like I'm doing more than I actually am. If it was 60 minutes, then I'd be like, all right, I feel like I'm doing less than I really am. But if I was spot on, then I'm just a modern day marvel. I'm just a Gainzologist. I really don't know. I definitely don't want to know because I feel like stopping. Physically, I want to stop. Mentally, I want to achieve my goal. So how do I do that? Yeah, I just keep on. Ignore your physical dilemmas and listen to your mind. See, knowing where I'm at right now is going to either inspire me to keep going or discourage me. So I can't risk finding out. I know I'm not at my goal because it would take me like 3 hours. But you also be surprised how fast time passes when you're going your flow. It's the same deal. Slow is smooth, and smooth is fast. And as long as we're clicking, we're clicking. So when my phone went on, I saw the time, not intentionally. So I know I'm closer to like an hour, which is good. Because now I know this is the best hour of Navy SEALs I've ever had. That makes me feel like I'm closer to 200. Right? Maybe not. But it's possible. But unlikely, because I'm going mad slow. Even though I'm not taking prolonged rest, I still think I'm more likely somewhere around 150. You know, and no matter what this number is, if I look at it, I'll be like, damn, it's a long way from where I want to be. But if I just keep clicking, and allow time to do what time does. And just over the course of the time of me continuing to go, one click at a time, I'm gonna hit a number that I'll be more satisfied with. Getting a headache, so drink some water. Maybe that'll help me erase her. My shoulders, I don't know. Actually, I think I did 200, maybe 200 and change. 5 pump Navy SEALs with Jibe on a live. It was on his channel. I just looked at it the other day, or this today, and I said, okay. I was making progress. Well, even if all I did was 100, I'd still be satisfied with my performance today. It wasn't fast, but it was with purpose, it was with effort. I feel good. Feel good. But I wonder, I don't know what number I'm gonna get to. I think if I do like another hour, say like an hour, 15 minutes, I could still handle all the things I gotta do today and still get to bed at a decent time. Winding down. See if it's recording. It's going. God, I want to look. I want to look because there's a numerical value that if I looked at it, I would keep going. But there's also a numerical value that if I looked at it, I would just stop or round it off. I would keep going to round it out and get ready for dinner. Definitely ready to stop. My wrist hurts the most. You know, say what you will about my reps and pace, but this is by far my best Navy SEALs performance of my lifetime. Really because of my breathing, and it's because of my pacing. Rather than trying to drop, pop, be explosive, that's what messes me up. Like this, I allow myself to work into the flow. My heart rate never accelerated to the point where I wanted to stop. I got serious pumped because I was really trying to have higher quality reps. Definitely feel great. I feel great. I feel like I got the workout I needed. I made progress, good performance. I lasted a duration, a respectable duration. We don't know if I hit a respectable rep count. But I tell you what, we're somewhere around an hour and a half, right? And I know that because I saw the time when I looked to see if it was still recording. So I think my average was generally 80 per hour. Is that right? Because I find it hard to believe. All right, let's be realistic, right? Brother Derek did 120 minutes. He was obviously going way faster than me. So let's say I did half of that. So that's 50 per 20 minutes. That's 50, 100, 150 per hour, right? 50, 150 per hour. I should at least be on 225. If I'm at half the pace that Brother Derek was for his 20 minutes. So if I'm at 225, if I'm at less than that, I'll be disappointed. I'm not gonna lie. If I'm at less than 225, I'll be disappointed. See, so that makes me want to continue and stuff. Yeah, I want to keep going, but I'm going to be super disappointed if when I do look, it's under 225. You know? That'll crush my spirits. But if I was, I would be like, all right, I could push to 250. I made half my goal. If I'm at 250, I could probably push to 300. Right? That's 3/5 my goal, 60%, gains loaded. If I was on like 350, you're gonna have to go. You're gonna have to do 150 more, bro. You're here already. So I'm trying to gauge how I feel, because if I did 200, let's say I did 200, that's 600 push-ups. How do I generally feel after 600 push-ups? I usually feel worse than how I feel right now. So then now that makes me think maybe I did less. I'm just overanalyzing it. That's part of the fun for me. It's a tactic to distract me and to motivate me. It's like negative reinforcement, positive reinforcement, distraction, killing time, talking and breathing. A lot of dynamics to allow me to continue to just keep going one click at a time. Psychological warfare. Look, I got a notification. G-Bay, there's no escape from suffering. 200 Navy SEALs, 28 minutes, 59 seconds. I'm over here, hour and a half in, three times the amount of time, wondering if I have the same value as him. Think about that. Salute. At least, you know, I'm gonna tell you, I'm gonna steal your whole title. There's no escape from suffering. 200 Navy SEALs. 1 hour and 28 minutes, 59 seconds. Yeah, but salute to him, bro. It's amazing. Amazing. It's amazing what people are capable of, right? And that's what I needed to see. You know what? Let me play his video. I'm gonna play his video. Shout out to you. Shout out to you. Great time to post it. But you don't talk enough.
Okay. Welcome. Time for some Navy SEAL burpees.
You just...
That's why I clicked on the video. See me, some Navy SEAL burpees.
Fact.
If you click through the video, see the end, I'm destroying myself. Well, it's all good. And the most important thing is my own training. I'm still in some kind of
training
phase to get better.
I don't know.
200, because there's a nice intermediate version of what I was doing.
Like, I don't know if I've been clicking.
300, now 200. Cool, simple to get under 30 minutes. And just see where I stand with that.
Hold on. I don't make sense, bro. You see, I was flapping my gums. I don't know if I was clicking. I really don't know. So it goes back to what I said in the beginning while I was doing it so I could have the muscle memory. Hopefully, my muscle memory was clicking because I have no idea. So.
Let's go.
Thank you. Because I was ready to quit. Say it again.
More time again.
Listen.
I know. There may be a lot of the same stuff, but only to repetition and practice, you get better. And if I have more time again, I gotta incorporate more and other stuff.
Thank you. Now, I'm gonna keep going for the rest of your video.
Let's go.
That's 30 minutes of inspiration. Ah, don't count out loud, bro. You embarrass me.
Two.
I gotta maintain my own flow. I'm just not on. No, no, he's up.
Six. Seven.
You know, when a fat guy walks the trails, he don't chase after the marathon runner. He just walk around and he just walk up on trails. That's what I'm doing. Now it hurts.
21.
Now I'm on fire.
22. 23. 24. Yeah.
just heard crazy. I don't think he mentioned if it was unbroken or not. No, it probably was.
44.
We'll see. It's still going. Yeah, I'm done after this video. A step closer. I know I need at least 3 hours. So. I could do cardio tomorrow. I was gonna say I could take a rest day, but I'll get on the row machine. Let's do some rows.
If you want to start making 3K, 5K, or even 10K a month in passive income, women love a guy that takes good care of his face. If you need some help in the department, Lumen has you covered. You can take a
For the record, if I wasn't working out with you, if I was just watching, I probably let the ass play a little bit. Oh, I don't know if I would get a copyright for your ad playing. So I guess GJ does a shot caller in 60 minutes. Maybe 90 minutes. That's how I know it's gonna take me 3 hours. I've done the math before. So I don't know if I missed any clicks. I feel like I might have. But I said in the beginning, the only thing that counts is the number. If I miss the click, that doesn't count.
Thank you.
Might even steal your thumbnail. Hey, man. My reps slow down dramatically, but still faster than usual. If you haven't seen me do Navy SEALs. We're still going. All right, about to hit 2 hours. Shout out to me.
50.
Shout out to me. 60. I never did 2 hours in 86, I don't think. See, so part of me is like, hey, it's 200. Well, I mean, it's 2 hours. See what number you want. See, if that's a reasonable number for you to keep pressing on to 3 hours to get to 500. But just how I distracted myself so I could make it 2 hours. I don't know my number. If I could distract myself, after this video, 15 minutes. I'm gonna see what number I'm on. If I'm over 400, I'll keep going. If I'm under 400, I'm gonna pack it in. I didn't make it. If I'm over 400, I'm gonna just do one by one. I'll play another video. I see who else just posted. Hopefully somebody posted something. Just 2 hours, I didn't really have a prolonged rest. Wouldn't say it was unbroken or nothing like that. But for my pace and abilities, it was consistent. So that in itself is progress. No, I'm definitely, I'm deep. See, if I average 200 per hour, I will be on 400 right now. I can't imagine that. You know? Even though, well, he did 230 minutes. So that's 400 in an hour. Hour and a half for him. So I'm not gonna be that close. I'll be lucky if I'm at 350. I don't know. I'll tell you how I feel about my reps when I know what it is. Two hours in Navy SEALs is a PR for me, I think. And 500 will be 1,500 push-ups. I feel like I did 1,000. This is generally how I feel at 1,000. No slumping. Can never play a video without a siren in the background. I don't think I have one video without a siren in the background. It's crazy. Slump over, not one time. Thank you. I'm done. I'm finished and I'm done. That's it. Yeah, go. Let's see where we are. 2 hours is it? 2 hours and 9 minutes. Let's see where we are. No, 10 more.
I was feeling awesome in the beginning, but still, that feels I gotta stack up. There's no escaping suffering with Navy Shields. That is guaranteed. Still, good training. Building, putting the box up, building the fundament. Soon,
hello? Yeah, okay. I'll call you back in 5 minutes. One more time.
Four sets, five gaps. Slow, on top.
G, man. Super disappointed. Super disappointed. Not even gonna say what the number is. Six more. Put it this way. It sucks. Unbelievable. And I train to go faster. It's fucking slow and smooth and smooth as fast shit is a bold-faced lie. Still my best performance, it's just the worst in the industry. Four more for round number. I'll finish, but I don't have 2 more hours available. Ridiculous. But this is my best. So that's something to be proud of for me. Something for me to think about. And I gotta improve this, but that shot call is a long way away. It's 297. I was gonna put in the title anyway. It is what it is. So disappointing. Sucked the life out of me. So I didn't want to look. Imagine if I'd have looked earlier. I'd have quit. It might be a PR for me, which is cute, but. At least I can say I did over 300, more than 300. Hey, it's Gainz. Salute. Keep working hard. Practice. Gainz.